Hey, what's happening everyone? Jack Salvo here again with another video, and today is going to be pick up and review episode 4, and I'm not doing this alone today. Unfortunately, we have a guest with us. She's been bugging to be on my channel for a while. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my sister, Charlotte.
Actually, you wanted me on the channel, but anyway.
No, I didn't. You asked me to be on this. You wanted me to be. By the way, she's not from NXT either, so don't ask.
I don't have a clue what that is, anyway.
She's a diva from NXT. She's Ric Flair's daughter, so. Anyway, first time we're going to be talking about from Sanity. It is the Blu-ray edition of Daniel Bryan. Just Say Yes, Yes, Yes. That's a lot better. Yes, yes, yes. This is only $35. I haven't watched it yet, but I'm really keen to. It looks awesome.
It's gonna be really bad, what? Just like your face.
Oh, that's so rude. Like, so honestly. True. So have a look at the back there. Open this up. 2 discs. Let's just move that there. All right. That's a lot better. So this is pretty much the journey to WrestleMania 30, documentary that's on there, and a whole bunch of matches of your favorite wrestler. Daniel Bryan. Please tell the viewers your love for Daniel Bryan. Go tell them.
He's a douchebag.
Why is Daniel Bryan a douchebag?
All he says is, yes, yes, yes,
but that's
yes.
Why people love him.
That's why I hate him.
But he's a great wrestler. Like,
I don't care if he's the best wrestler in the world. He's annoying.
Which he is. Ugh. Whatever. She doesn't watch wrestling, obviously. Yes. Next item is from EB Games. I was looking through some of the pop vinyls there, and I found this. It is Stewie Griffin from Family Guy. I love this show, so Family Guy is awesome. Do you like Family Guy? Yeah, she likes Family Guy. So this is Stewie Griffin. This was the one I saw. Let's open. There we go. Here he is. He's so tiny. Why does he look like an Asian?
Racist.
How is that racist?
Racist.
Asians.
Racist.
No. So this is Asian Stewie here. He's got his little football hair and his cute little overalls with his teddy bear, Rupert. Very, very cool. Can't wait to put that up with all my other pop vinyls. Your thoughts on this?
Yeah.
You like it?
So sweet.
Of course it's sweet. It's amazing. Then we got to the reject shop and...
This is where it went downhill.
Yeah, this is where it really went downhill, but we're not going to talk about that yet. We're going to be talking about these KISS 360 cards that were released back in 2009. We found them in like a bargain bin. They're only $1 each. They're all the same cover. Like, you don't have to show them individually.
Yeah, I do. Some people are blind. Okay, Jack.
Okay. So let's open some of these. You want to open up a packet?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So let's fucking open these. Got one open? Alright, got. Alright, so what have you got? Show the viewers. So we have a Paul Stanley card from 1974. Oh, we got a 2009 picture of the band there. Got a Paul Stanley bit behind Starry Eyes. It's just throw on the cards. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Gene Simmons from 2009.
That's during the Sonic Boom album. Then we have a cool little snapshot one. Really awesome. 1975 in San Francisco. There's Gene there.
Whoever that is, looks like a girl, but anyway.
Ace Frehley doesn't look like a girl.
Yeah, he does.
No, he doesn't. Yeah, he kicks ass. So we have an album one. This is from Unmasked, released in 1980. That one?
Oh, definitely.
You got
the album one?
The original debut KISS album.
Yeah.
We have Eric Singer card there, amped up. Stop throwing my cards, seriously.
And this is some.
That's Gene Simmons, Breathing Fire.
I do.
Then we'll open this other card. See what we got here. We have another 2009 fan rooted tour. Does it say rooted?
Yeah. Feral.
Feral. I'm just saying what. Though we have another behind the curtain one of Ace Frehley from 1974 there. What else? Oh my god. This one's soaked in blood.
Oh, Jack, disgusting!
Of Paul Stanley, Under the Covers, Road Stories. Oh, it's like a little story one. Then we have a Welcome to the Show Kiss card from the Destroyer album, probably. Then we have another album cover, Alive 2. And yeah, that's it. So
this is the... couldn't get anything better than this next item.
Oh, this is the highlight, definitely.
The whole...
I've seen...
best to last.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of great wrestling items in my time, but this... it's fantastic. Oh, dropping the card. Yep. I present to you the greatest wrestling product of all time.
Have to agree.
The wrestling playset.
Yep.
Oh my god.
How much was it, Jack?
$3, obviously. You see, it says hero with a little outline of a wrestler.
Wouldn't want to waste
it's
that money.
$3+. There's a little Rey Mysterio in the background.
Let's open it up so we can
see. And Tornado, whatever. Alright, let's open this up. We've got a six-sided ring. We've got a TNA ring. But that's not working.
There it is. Look. Oh. Look, see, yeah.
Oh, there's one of the turnbuckles. Couldn't have done it. No, I could have done it without you.
Couldn't have, actually.
Yeah, you could. Alright, so, yeah, dropping figures.
There's like a band thingy, whatever.
Can you even... you can't even move them.
He's apparently stuck like a monkey dude.
What? What kind of BS is this? So you can't even move these figures.
I just love the detail of their faces. Let me just show you that.
Yeah, just look at the Great Khali's face. That's who it was based on.
That's just beautiful.
Then we have John Cena. That's the best he's ever looked. Then we have this shitty Jeff Hardy custom.
They all look like monkeys.
Well, they kind of do look like
monkeys.
Yeah,
they do look like monkeys.
Look at Jeff Hardy's screaming face. It's like, ah! And then we have the six-sided TNA ring. What does it say on here? Oh, God. King's Superpower. Are they talking about King from Tekken or whatever? So we have Smack. And what is... Super Force Top Speed. That sounds like a new Power Rangers series. And that all it says in the back. So let's put this together. So, what do you think of this ring? Do you think it's like... how would you rate it out of 10? Just...
probably like a 2.5.
I'd rate this like 12.
If... 12 out of 10, seriously.
Yeah, but... what? I think it's disappointing that you cannot, like...
move the figures.
Yeah. So they're like pop vinyls in a way. They're kind of based off like the microaggression figures that were released by Jack Specific.
Does it matter what colour it is next?
Not really. Okay. Okay, so...
the assembly of this is pretty easy, though, so it's pretty
yeah. Cool. How do you think of the six-sided ring? Do you think that's a pretty cool thing, other than the traditional four-sided?
Not really.
Really? So you wouldn't like TNA, then?
No, I don't really care.
You don't really care about TNA?
I don't really care about wrestling.
I blame you for not caring about TNA. Like, well, I think they have Kurt Angle taking on EC3 on Impact.
What does that even mean?
Kurt Angle is the world champion. He is wrestling Ethan Carter III.
Who's Ethan something the third?
He was in WWE. He was Derek Bateman, but he was pretty much a jobber there, so...
whatever that means, yeah.
That means he always loses.
Okay, yeah.
So, yeah, this is our TNA six-sided ring done. Oh, and we came with little steel steps, so that's awesome. Where does this go, anyway? This is... alright, let's have Cena versus Mr. Kennedy. And alright, so his knob is on the rope there. That's awesome. Yeah, what do you think was the best item out of all of these?
Definitely this.
Yeah. 10 out of 10.
Takes the cake.
If you find this, please do not get it.
Comment if you get this.
Give her hate comments. Please give her a lot of hate comments. Actually, no, please, because they probably would. Anyway, this is going to be it for this video. Hope you guys have enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like if you did. You probably won't because she's in it.
Subscribe.
Thanks for saying that. Comment down below whatever you
about
want.
About how amazing I am and how stupid this...
just do the complete opposite of what she just said.
Exactly what I said.
Check me out on Twitter and Instagram at JackamanLove31. And I will see you guys later, and hopefully we don't see her ever again.
Oh, you will, don't you?
And I am out in 3, 2, 1.
Jackman Lowell.